Good day! This is the intro for the full comparison video for the SoundLogic HD Wi-Fi version. For the unboxing and basic information, check the corner up there. Most of this will be filmed while riding a motorcycle for the best comparison.
Let's see. Angle might be crooked. And it might be some vibrations due to the fact it's on the steering wheel, but time will tell. I film with the Firefly on the chest. It gets the benefit of at least having the same color settings, the same outside colors, the same wheel colors, same light, stuff like that. Filmed on the same day in the same area with the same lighting should give the best comparison.
What you do see here with the SoundLogic is a little bit of flickering. This is the image stabilization, which for some reason is very difficult for this cheap camera to handle and changes the look.
What I quickly can see is that it is blinking, so it's recording. The SD card is present. Whichever time he says it is, and how many battery life there's left, and how long he has been recording. Obviously, if I'm gonna use this camera normally, I'm gonna twist it around. The weird thing is, I had to mount it there instead of on my handlebar because of the angle of the mount situation. I also noticed that the Firefly is only half battery, so I don't know how long it will last. Let's turn motion detection off.
Image does bounce a little bit more without the image stabilization.
I must say, I am in the need of a toilet. I have a terrible headache. And it's only halfway my work day yet. I think I'm gonna jump on the highway up ahead already, as that makes more sense than staying in the boring straights.
You do see some vibration from the steer.
Like I said, also I'm going from work location to work location, so it can't take too long. So this makes more sense. Let's see how the SoundLogic does the highway. Look at that! Okay, we're gonna lane split with three cameras. Also not that bad. So the downside of this comparison is that this camera is at an angle and on the steering wheel. So not the fairest comparison.
Quickly, back purple looks very nice on the camera. Downside of the image stabilization, as you can see, the begin of the timeline is all very, very short clips. The moment I turn the image stabilization off, it turns in long, normal, usable clips. So definitely rock this camera without the stabilization. It also seems to improve the battery life. We will come back to that later. And it seems to improve quality of the image. Although it will stay a little bit yellow compared to the Firefly and the Drift. That's probably just sensor, light sensor wise. It isn't dead yellow, but you can see it on the white lines on the tarmac.
So the traffic jam there is now worse, but I'm going this way. So either it is facing straight but an angle, or it is facing out but level.
Okay, another quick thing I want to share. This is the Firefly used in the footage today. And other than that, this one is a bit fatter. Another big change is this one has a screw, standard size. For example, the selfie stick, which I tend to use sometimes. or for a tripod or whatever stand, this one lacks it, so this one can only fit in its case. This case has a lock on it, which is good to know. Another thing is this one is quite sturdy, quite heavy. This one fell from the bike. As you can hear, something is loose in there, but it works perfectly still, even the audio. This one feels very plasticky, so I'm not quite sure if this one will survive a fall. You might find out at some point. Let's see in the tunnel. And very interesting, there it isn't yellow, where the Twift and the Firefly are yellow. Here it shows quite white. I almost want to say that Sound Logic is the best of the three here, although the Firefly looks more clear. So with the Firefly, it's fucking up the case, and the Sound Logic case isn't fucking up, so that's interesting.
Look at that.
Also notice is how quickly after we exit the tunnel image comes back, and the Sound Logic did that quite well.
Ooh, a roundabout, they changed this into a roundabout. Interesting. Now Moto Jinji has a knee down practice circle. I should put it up, but it's fucking late. I still have a bloody headache. So I'm gonna go home. This, however, does give a good chance to give the camera, the Sound Logic, a night view test. I'm just gonna compare it to my Drift, which doesn't have the best night view, but just a quick comparison. The Firefly set we recorded 45 minutes. And he did that with half a battery. This one also recorded 45 minutes. Because they recorded roughly the same time. And he only has one bar left from a full battery. So the 15 minutes recording time is probably correct. But the Firefly has a longer battery then.
Again, night view looks color-wise better on the Sound Logic. This is 20 minutes later and still recording, so it has an hour, a little bit more, recording time.
Almost home. And it's actually still recording. Battery life is red and blinking, so critical, but he's still recording. Not bad, because it's roughly another 20 minutes or so.
It also plays back at 29 point something frames, so you need to change when editing. I've decided to keep it. I've decided to use it without stabilization, as you have seen the footage that looks better without. The main reason why I'm keeping it is for the mount. Even though the mount, which I don't have here, if you clamp it on the steering like this, it faces sideways. But I can fix it in the position you see in the video, and that works fine for me. It gives a good, nice angle, and I might fix this one on there. So yeah, the end verdict for the Sound Logic: 15 euros, yeah, worth it. 25, maybe. Anything more than that, probably not. Target audience: people that film maybe a handful of times per year. When you go on vacation or whatever. People might think about vlogging, but are not sure yet. Try it with this cheap ass camera. Or people just want to stick a camera on their car, motorcycle, scooter, whatever, for insurance reasons. Quality is good enough, you can fix the date in it. It comes with a warranty, so yeah, not the best, not a main camera. If you want to do proper content, you are slowly growing, probably not even your best secondary camera, but a useful nonetheless, I think. Just to have it laying around, being available.
So that was the main comparison for now. thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the notification bell. And I hope this video could be in any way, shape, or form to any use for you.